My name is Marina Kalashnikova, and I'm a researcher at the Marx Institute for Brain Behavior and Development at Western Sydney University. Our research focuses primarily on how children learn their language. Language is one of the most complex cognitive systems that a human being can acquire. And we are the only species in the world that can acquire language, and even machines up to date are not prepared to learn language in the same way as humans do. But our tiny babies who cannot sit straight or who cannot tie their shoes are already masters in that system. My area specifically focuses on how the language that infants hear in the environment influences their early language acquisition. So babies start listening to speech from very, very early on in the development and start intaking information from that. In fact, we know from research that babies are already learning about their language when they're still in the womb. So our auditory system develops when we are in the third trimester of pregnancy. So the fetus is already perceiving speech that is coming from the environment and primarily from their mother's voice. So when they come to the world, the babies already have very advanced knowledge about the language that they're going to speak. And from then on, they continue listening to what is happening around them to learn the different aspects of their language. So those aspects include sounds, the rhythm of their language, how syllables can be constructed, which are the appropriate words of their language, and further on up to how to construct sentences or how to use language in different social situations. Infant-directed speech is a type of speech that we produce unconsciously and spontaneously when we are in front of a baby, and everybody who's ever seen a baby has probably done it. And it is distinguished from adult-directed speech, so we tend to produce speech that is higher in pitch and that has more varied intonation. Others are visual characteristics, so we tend to smile more when we speak to babies, also raise our eyebrows, widen our eyes. And others are more structural, so for example, we exaggerate the sounds that we produce in our speech. We also tend to make our sentences simpler. So it is suggested that it is not just a cute way of speaking to babies, but we actually make our language easier for them to learn and to acquire. Now, another interesting question is why we produce infant-directed speech in the first place and how this special register developed. It is still one of the main questions that we are trying to answer in our research. But one of the indications that we have from previous studies is that infant-directed speech may have an evolutionary antecedent. So for example, in situations where we started foraging, the infant needed to go on the ground near the mother. And of course, as we know, infants start getting distressed as soon as they leave their mother's arms. So we believe that the mothers at that point developed this tendency to produce higher pitch vocalizations that could comfort and soothe their babies and also transmit a non-threatening intention to them while the babies were separating from it. And what is fascinating is that we're not the only species to do that. Birds also produce infant-directed vocalizations and also other primates. So for example, different mammals tend to produce higher pitch vocalizations when they approach their offspring, because a higher pitch denotes a smaller vocal tract or a smaller shaped animal, so we're less likely to appear threatening to our offspring. So we believe that humans adapted that animal behavior that later developed into this useful tool in which we can soothe our babies but also facilitate the task of learning language to them. What we do know that infants prefer their mother's voice when it is compared to a different female's voice from their first hours of life. So that also demonstrates that infants are hearing their mother's voice while they're still in the womb. And they also prefer infant-directed speech compared to adult-directed speech. So if a newborn is played a recording of adult-directed speech and infant-directed speech, they tend to listen longer to infant-directed speech because that's a more soothing and more interesting speech for them. And we also know from several studies now that infants' brain actually reacts differently to infant-directed speech compared to adult-directed speech. We see more activity in the neurons and a greater blood flow, which shows that there is greater arousal in the brain, which could denote that it's more prepared for intaking information and to learning from the speech and the environment.